Hello friends, good morning. Welcome back to our channel ARP Talks. This is your Lakshmipathy. Today we have Mr. Srikanth with us. He has very experience on earthing and lightning solutions and all. We discussed a lot of things. So it's very good discussion. So I hope this discussion will help you. Yeah, for watching this video, you may not be electrical engineer. Anyone who is interested to know all this stuff, they can watch it. Yeah, what happens if painting is there, whether proper earthing is there or not, what are the different materials we will use for earthing, what are the different chemical composition, so what are the different types of lightning arrangement, lightning related protections we are taking care. So some stuff we discussed it. We are going to do many more videos also in future with our combination. Yeah, thank you. Keep watching this video till the end so you can get some good understanding. If you have any questions or comments or anything, then please comment in comment section. So thank you guys, keep watching. Hello Srikanth, good afternoon.
Yes sir.
I hope today we will have a very good session.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah. Last time we had some issues. Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Yes, sir. Yes. Okay. Welcome back to our channel, ARP Talks.
Yes, sir. Yep. If there...
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, sir. Yes.
Nice to meet you. So yeah, it's your turn. You start about yourself, your professional and educational background, so that it's good for our audience. You proceed.
Yes. Sir, yesterday there was a network problem, so we could not continue.
Yes. No issue.
We're going to discuss on lightning protection and earth.
Yes.
So currently I have done some MSc DCL transmission distribution projects, sir. Having experience in design field in water pumping station designs, commercial, residential, industrial factories, electrification, power distribution scheme design and detail engineering.
Okay. Nice. Yeah. So if directly we will jump into the topic. So lightning protection means what, why it is important, why we have to do, for which equipment we have to do, how we can check, like, is there any intensity, is there lightning means, like for example, 1 meter, 2 meter, 3 meter, like that we have for length, like that, what are the units for lightning related, how we can classify the intensity, what are the devices, if is there any devices are there to check it or something. So please explore it. Yeah.
Lightning, there are various countries where lightning in flashes are occurring, means intensity is large mm-hmm. number of lightning strokes take place in rainy seasons or mm-hmm. In a whole year.
Okay.
So due to the lightning, there is a damage to the properties, human life. So we must give protection for the lightning and lightning is causing over voltages in electrical installations. Electrical equipments are damaged due to that over voltages.
Okay.
There can be a fire also.
Okay. So
we shall provide protection for the lightning.
Okay. So
for that we can nowadays there is IS 2309 according mm-hmm. to that in India we can provide protections according to that Indian standard, also international standard IEC 60325 I think.
Okay.
That mm-hmm. is also giving detailed information about the protections to be provided as per to the electrical installations.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Various equipments we can use for the protection, such as surge protecting device is there, lightning mm-hmm. arrestor is there, rod gap we can provide at the transformer terminals mm-hmm. on HV side.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Search counter is there, means lightning stroke counter is there, means we can count the number of lightning strokes happening in the year.
Okay.
We have to provide earthing strip is there, means horizontal vertical air terminal is there, horizontal conductor is there, down conductor is there, earthing rods, means earthing electrode. We have to ground that, we have to discharge all the that charge which is coming from the lightning into the ground.
Okay.
Without damage to our property and human life.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. So lightning, for example, say we will use some GI flat and all for earthing purpose. That is clear. So at the top of the tower or say building, how we are capturing that lightning? I mean, what we are using at that place? If it is normal MS, means how it is? Can you explain a bit about that?
There is a charge in cloud, means positive and negative. Means positive charge on our side, and cloud is negatively charged. So there a streamer is formed between means highly conductive and low resistance path is there. So it flow, it attracts to the charge in the cloud.
Okay.
So this way we can discharge that the charge in into the ground.
So is this copper or aluminium or normal GI or MS is okay, that whatever electrode we are using, generally what is the standard outside, what standard says for that material of that?
Currently early streamer earth electrodes are provided, means highly conducting material. And flat strips are so normally we can means concentration of the people in that premises, we can provide good earth lightning protection system. And suppose there is a hospital or there is a industry factory which is very highly costly, so we can provide better equipments, advanced equipments. Normal building we can provide GI MS strip also, as a horizontal and vertical air terminal of copper. And down conductor, down conductor GI MS strip is also okay.
Okay. So whatever you are placing on the air, is this a normal plain conductor or a plain MS, or we are painting or GI galvanic? How it will be there in ground?
There to oppose resist rusting, there it is painted to avoid rusting.
I have some doubt here. If for avoiding rusting we should be GI or painting, but if you plane is something very good, right, for earthing purpose, plane conductor is very good, right, for providing earthing.
MS yes, it is it gets more contact with the soil.
Yeah, that is true. But if you, for rusting point of view, if you paint it, that is not perfect earthing, right? What you say?
But we are giving low resistance part through the electrode, na? So
okay,
it is also okay. So life of the earthing grid is more if we are giving it covering of the insulation.
Okay.
I think it would be very for little time, it will be not long life, that paint will go away because of heating of that strip.
Okay.
Whenever there is a earth fault current, it will heat that.
Yeah.
The paint will go away.
Okay. So generally in any plants, power plants or any industry, so the earth grid will be there, mesh will be there. It may be at one place,
yes.
Right? They can't run throughout the plant, they can't run. So in those cases, how the situation is? For example, say we have 1 acre big land is there, a company industry. So there are so many earthing lightning arrestor masks are there for collecting all the lightning. So how we are connecting this entire, say you have 10 different lightning masks. How we are connecting all those poles into this earthing grid? It is too far, right? Is it okay, or can you explain a bit here?
As per feasibility, means we can give dedicated earthing pits also for separate earthing pits at that location, or we can connect it to the earthing grid. which is also cables. Cables are armoring also earth at the ends.
Mm-hmm.
Cable sheath and cable armor. If those plants are connected through the cable,
mm-hmm.
then we can ground that cable armoring.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Generally, we use only GI or MS, right? I mean, we don't use cables, right? Haan, generally. Cast iron.
Yes.
Due to costly.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yes. Cost. Cost factor is there.
Okay. Okay. Mm-hmm. So, in market generally, what type of lighting protection devices are available? You told about monitoring, lightning monitor. So, it would lightning monitor, it will count number of lightnings in a year or something like that. So, is there, what are the other devices generally available?
I don't get the question, sir.
Yeah, what are the different types of lightning protection devices available?
Yes, surge protection device, SPD is there, sir. SPD is there.
Okay.
Lightning arrester is there.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Lightning arrester is there.
Okay.
And rod gap we can provide at the transformer.
Yeah, generally rod gap is only at transformer, right? No other place.
Yes. At the transformer.
Okay. Yeah, SPD means surge protection device means what? I mean, what will be there in that device? Where it will be installed? Can you explain a bit?
It is a shunt type device.
Shunt type device.
It is connected between phase and earth.
Okay. Okay. Is this like a normal lightning arrester or little bit something different?
Construction in there is a miss. I have not gone through the construction.
No issue. Yeah, no problem.
Non-linear resistors are provided in lightning arrester. Resistors are provided. Yes, sir.
Yeah, generally that is the case.
At normal operation, it should not conduct.
Yes.
Only in case of lightning surges, will be conducting, and also there gap also is provided.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
In LA.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So in say for example, plant is ready. Plant, everything is set up in plant, your industry, earthing solutions, lighting solutions. Everything is ready. For example, how we will check everything is okay? Can you explain it? Say you have been auditing work. You have been given auditing or testing work. So how we will check everything is okay?
Mm-hmm. Earthing resistance is to be less, means up to one ohm.
Mm-hmm.
We can measure the earthing resistance by earth tester.
Okay. What is that meter name? Earth tester, sir. Okay, earth tester.
Earth tester.
Okay. Oh, is there any separate meter for that? Like ohm meter?
Yes, sir. Ohm meter means, okay, yes, sir.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So is this only less than 1 ohm is sufficient, or there are different conditions for different purpose of earthing like that?
But we have to give minimum value. We have to obtain minimum value adding resistors. Means we have to provide low resistance path. We cannot exceed 1 ohm for larger power plants.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, what types of different earthings are there? Is this because I say in rod earthing, plate earthing, pipe earthing, something different types are there? Can you explain a bit about that?
Generally classification, we can provide TT type earthing,
mm-hmm.
TN type earthing, IT type earthing.
Mm-hmm.
TN earthing has means there is a system earthing and equipment earthing. These two type of earthings.
Yes. Yeah.
These major types are there. Mm-hmm. Means type of earthing and there after then we can provide pipe earthing, plate earthing. These are general.
Okay.
But earthing systems are also different one.
Okay. Generally, when we will use the plate earthing, when we will use pipe earthing, when we will use only normal rod earthing, can you explain what is the differences? Which application needs which earthing?
We can use pipe and plate or strip earthing, mere strip also, but we have to maintain the low resistance path, sir.
Okay.
We can miss application. We have to ground the fault current more, which can give more effective grounding discharge capability. We have to use that. Pipe earthing is good. Pipe gives more exposure to the ground.
Okay.
Surface area is in contact with the earth is more in pipe earthing.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So, are you using normal charcoal or NaCl or water or any other chemicals you are using for earthing?
Bentonite, chemical earthing is also available, which is maintenance free.
Mm-hmm.
So, maintenance free earthing is good one.
Yeah.
Nowadays means advanced techniques we are using.
Okay. Chemical earthing means generally what is the chemical? I mean, what is that? Is this powder or liquid or solid or... Can you explain a bit what is the composition of material?
Mm-hmm. Bentonite is there.
Bentonite? Okay. Uh-huh. Okay. Can you share the details of that of later? That chemical composition of details?
I will share. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
I will share that chemical earthing. Technical details. Specification.
Yes, that's good.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes,
mm-hmm. So, body earthing means generally wherever, what are the places you will use body earthing?
Body earthing is just metallic parts, which are not in contact with the live parts of the equipment. That may be frame of that equipment.
Okay.
It must be isolated from the live parts in that equipment. So we are in contact with that frame, maybe their door or frame that has a earthing connection.
Okay.
And we have to give earthing to the to connect to that earthing that point to the earth.
Okay.
We have to bring all the equipments body earthing at the equipotential.
Okay.
Also there may be some conducting metals around, means maybe pipeline, metallic pipeline, that we have to bond all those together at one potential, which will avoid touch potentials.
Okay. Yeah. Did you have any bad experience with insights with respect to earthing and lightning and all? Any difficulties, any problems? Can you explain a bit about that? Because you are working inside, you might face so many things, some hurdles. Say after commissioning 1 or 2 years, as we may face some burning issue, some explosion. I am not sure, but I am asking you, what are the problems there generally? Can you explain?
Sir, one time there was a neutral cut, and neutral cut, due to that neutral cut, over voltage was there in means phase to neutral voltage was equal to phase to phase voltage. That was burning the many equipments. So if there is a neutral cut, voltage unbalance occurs. So voltage phase to phase voltage comes in phase to neutral voltage.
Where is disconnected? I mean, where neutral is disconnected?
At the transformer end, it was disconnected. Or it may be in also 3-phase, 4-line supply where industries are there, if neutral get cut.
Mm-hmm.
So that was the problem I experienced. Means it was related to earthing also. Earthing was also open. Earthing terminal was also open there.
Yeah, is this burned or intentionally someone opened and forgot to reconnect it?
It was burned due to the unbalancing of the loading. Due to the unbalanced loading, it was burned. Yes. Over voltages was due to the unbalancing.
Okay. So, what is the transformer rating in that case? Can you have you remember what is the size? 11 kV or 33 kV or 10 MVA, something like that. What is the details?
11 by 433. And rating was not that much. It was 250 kVA small transformer.
Okay, small transformer itself due to unbalance, it's burnt. Okay, yeah, it is very strange. Yeah, it's a little bit surprise for me because I am designing the transformers.
No,
okay.
Yes, sir. But it was external problem. It was external problem.
Yeah. It may be some external problem. Yes. Okay. So lightning related, did you face any issues? I mean, did you have any stories like that? What is the any problems?
Lightning related, not that much.
okay. No issue. That's good. We should not have any problems. If problems means it is somehow equipment damage, life related issues. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. In generally, in house we will have a grounding also in all our sockets. For 3-pin or 4-pin sockets, we will have some bigger terminal will be there. So we can say grounding terminal. Can you explain a bit about that? Generally,
yes.
Myself removed many times that wire connection. Because it's not required like that. So can you explain the importance of grounding in houses?
Yes, sir. Grounding, that leakage current must be grounded. And that terminal is of large area diameter is larger than other to provide the low resistance path.
Okay.
Due to the earthing, same voltage imbalance problem occurred, and earthing due to earthing, there is no proper earthing, voltage problem comes there. Voltage unbalance is there, so other equipments may not work properly.
Okay.
Due to earth fault.
Yeah.
And if there is no RCCB, we cannot find where that earth fault has occurred.
Oh, RCCB means what?
Yes, sir. RCCB, residual current. RCCB, residual current circuit breaker.
Okay. Okay. Yes. Otherwise, it may be difficult.
Yes. Up to 300 milliampere ratings are available in market.
Okay.
So it will detect the leakage current. Means there may be sometimes means phase is touched with earthing means metallic part, and small leakage current is flowing, and other equipments may get affected. Means they're not getting the proper voltage, because in a household there is a 230 volt supply.
Okay.
So other may not perform to their expected ratings. So that leakage must be found out.
Okay.
So yeah. We have to provide their RCCB.
I mean, are we using in today's RCCB in all places, or is this mandatory to use RCCB in houses, house buildings, and all?
Earth leakage protection is mandatory, sir. As per IE rules.
Okay. So generally you told about 300 milliamp. So how many milliamp generally we can prefer for our, say I want to have for my home, how many I can purchase?
30 milliamperes, 30. About 30 we get the shock. Means we can tolerate up to 30. Above 30 it is difficult for us to
okay.
Sustain that.
So is this like 30 milliamp?
30 milliamp.
Okay.
Ratings available in market may up to 300.
Okay. So whenever it is 30, I mean.
In some cases.
Yeah, proceed.
Some some cases tripping is not means they have to avoid tripping where some applications have to avoid tripping, so they are providing higher milliampere ratings.
Okay, yeah, understand. I mean, apart from normal household grounding and all, where other places, in which place we will use RCCB? Can you explain what are the other equipments where we will use this RCCB in the grounding connection?
Other equipments?
I mean, RCCB, where we will use in other devices?
It is in industrial and residential application.
Uh-huh. For example, are we using in motors and transformers, this RCCB?
No.
Okay. Mostly buildings, right?
Smaller loads.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Got it. Yeah. Okay. So, what are other devices for protection like RCCB? Do you have any other devices in market for protection?
For smaller leakage currents, RCCB is there. Mm-hmm. And other means earth fault protection for their means for higher ratings, earth fault protection relays are provided.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Means in coordination with the circuit breaker, we can provide earth fault relays.
Okay. So whenever more current is flowing in the earth, then it will give signals to circuit breaker, right?
Yes. Means there's CT will means there are core balance CT is there, means mm-hmm. which sends the earth fault current,
mm-hmm.
which will give signal to the relays, and relay will give tripping command to the breaker.
Okay. Yeah. So where we will install this earth fault relay? At which place we will install generally?
Suppose there is a transformer incomer, 11 kV incomer.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
There we can provide. There also on secondary side, if there is star connection or is incomer side, we can give restricted earth fault protection for the transformer.
Okay. If it is a delta connection, then a normal earth fault protection, right? If it is star, restricted earth fault protection.
Is a phase relay, phase over current.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Nice. Yeah, you explained a lot of things clearly.
Unbalancing will be sensed by that relay, a normal earth fault.
Okay.
Yes.
I think there is some delay in our voice. You may be listening maybe after 2-3 seconds like that. Okay, very nice. Very nice, Srikant. You explained.
There is a delay.
Yeah. Most of the parameters, what are we are using, some structural and all. Yeah, I seen the photos also you shared. Yeah, you try to share if you feel any good photos and all, you can share to me. And the chemical composition also you can share to me. Yeah, it's very nice because these things generally the graduates or other people don't know. Myself don't know actually. Very nice to discuss with you. Yeah. Thank you, man. This is not the end. This is just start. We are going to make many more videos also. Yeah. I want one thing from you. Whenever you say, for example, one plant is almost finished, means at that time I want a tour to the plant. Okay. You plan like that if you feel at any time.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
This is last day for me in this plant. So you can call me. Video call or something. You show me the how the thing protection devices are there. If possible, you take small snaps of videos, something, and we can just share to me because it will help a lot. Earthing is the main crucial role, protection.
Yes.
Because most people will do everything, but they neglect the earthing related. Actually, that is the main thing. If everything is smooth, means then okay.
Yes.
If something wrong means then life is going low. Going out. Yeah. So we have to create some little bit awareness on this thing related and all. Yeah. What best we can do. Yeah. Thank you. Thanks for today's discussion. Yeah. Okay, guys. Yes. Okay, dear. Stay right. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Nice.
Thank you.
So this is about lighting and earthing solutions, guys. I hope this is a small brief discussion only, not that much detail. So it will give some good understanding to you. Yeah, if you have any questions or comments or anything, then please comment in comment section. I'm ready to help you on those topics. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to this channel for many more updates. Bye. We will meet in next video.